I was scared of Dracula for 2 years. Hold up 2 fingers. Two years. Oh, no, over here. You're upstaging yourself. There you go. 2 years. Now I'm not afraid of him anymore. He's my friend. Yeah, that's it. Okay.
Draw in minutes by using letters and numbers with Buffalo Potato.
Boom! Ha ha! Children, it is I, Count Dracula. I am back, and I am here with my good friend, Muffle of the Baked Potato. How are you, my little red friend?
Hi, Dracula! Hi!
Yes, it is good to see you. And today, I'm going to show you how to draw a scarecrow. Very scary. Using nothing but numbers and letters, because that is the Muffle Potato way. And you need 3 things. You need a glove of garlic, you need a stake, and you need a cross. And you, wait a minute, that's the wrong thing. Hold on, no. Oh, you need a pen, a piece of paper, and you need to watch me. Are you ready, Muffalo?
Not really.
Good, we are doing it anyways. Okay, so start with your paper straight up and down. And the first thing you're going to draw is a zero, a nice little one right up here. Do not be afraid, it is just a zero. It goes around, around, and back up, and it touches. There is your zero. Now inside the zero, draw a lowercase n. Just like this, a little wider, there you go. And now, all across the end, do a few little X's. Oh, look at this, there's an X, there's an X, there's an X, and one more little one there. And do an X up here, all by itself. But on this side, draw another little zero, like this. Oh, there we go, and maybe 2 little dots inside it. Just like that, very nice. Now, across the bottom, I want you to draw an L, and then I want you to draw like a J, and that is the bottom of the scarecrow's throat.
Throat, it sounds funny.
But there's a funny word, isn't it?
I don't like
those. Yes, I like those. I don't know why, I just do. Hey, call me crazy, okay. Well, no, don't call me crazy.
Hi, John.
We flipped out. It's just okay. Me. Okay. Anyways, where was I? Oh, yes, of course. Turn the page sideways like this. And now I want you to draw a capital C, very long and very scary, like this. That will be the brim of our little scarecrow hat. And turn the scarecrow upside down because you are having fun with your paper and you don't care, really. No one really minds. You do whatever you want, okay? And here we're going to draw a J, like this, around and back again. It sounded like someone is playing baseball.
Baseball!
All right, and then you can draw an L, kind of like this, going down and a cross, and then you can do a couple pointy M's. There's an M, there's an M, and maybe here you can do a W like that, and maybe you do another W like that, and then you flip the page all the way around. Oh! Very scary. You think he's scary, Mahalo?
Not really, it's kind of cute.
Well, wait a minute, he'd be spooky later. If you were a crow, you'd be frightened, I'm telling you. Okay, now, we draw a big capital T, like big and across like this. It goes all the way across like this, and then it goes straight down, just like that. And on this side, a little beneath it, we do a number 7. Look, there is a 7, you see that? And then a big lowercase r on the other side. So it's 7TR. I don't know what it stands for, but it was fun. Okay, now at the bottom, some pointy W's. Pointy W's because this is the shirt the scarecrow wears. He does not have the best fashion sense and he has not gone to the cleaners. It is a little tattered on the bottom. Okay, now 3 buttons, 0, 0, 0. And he has straw for his arms, so they're. Is that a cricket?
Where are the crickets?
Now I hear a cricket. First a baseball, then a cricket. This place is haunted. Okay, now I draw a Z like this, and another Z, and maybe a Z here, and a W here, and then those are sort of like his crazy arms, okay? And then he needs one final thing. He needs a paw, because he is in the ground, and he is scaring the crows from eating the crumbs on a dark, dark, spooky night. So just a number 11, very, very long ones next to each other, and that is it. Okay, now, you look at it, and then what you do is you sound the gong! Oh, there it is, because we have just drawn a scarecrow using nothing but numbers and letters. Very spooky. Now we put him in the cornfield with a full moon, and maybe, I don't know, bats, but I will do it at high speed. Boop. Ah, boom, and there you have it. There you have a scarecrow in his field of dreams. If you look carefully, there is a little Kevin Costner, and he is listening to If You Build It, They Will Come. But most of you don't know what that means. But only a few of you do. And for you right now, you are laughing very hard. Mafo, did you have fun?
Kevin Costner.
Yes. So, draw your scarecrow using numbers and letters. Send it in to john@mafalopotato.com. Ask your parents' permission first. And remember, it does not have to be spooky. It just needs to be fun. We will see you with more great things to draw on Buffalo of the Potato. Bye-bye. Hear that bat sound again. We have bats in the belfry. Babe Ruth. Somebody.
The Buffalo Potato store is now open for business. Come on in. Backpacks. T-shirts. That spells awesome in my book. Perfect for holiday gifts, perfect for any time of year. Now you can dress just like your favorite drawing show. There's a good chance you're gonna look cooler than me. We've got Buffalo Potato stuff. It's exciting, and you can buy it.